Hi everybody and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to see how to play Special Forces Group 2 on PC. Here you're watching it on your screen. It will be possible to simply download and set up Special Forces Group 2 so that we can play your game on the Windows desktop or laptop with keyboard, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's go buddies! Before anything else mates, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can see on the screen. You don't need to type the URL, simply because there's the link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We ended up there on the website of Usitility, where we get a detailed description on how to download Special Forces Group 2 on personal computer. We search down a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we get to the website of LDPlayer. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Special Forces Group 2 on PC. As you can see from here, we have a great deal of advantages of preferring using this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instant synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and the list goes on. So we are ready to start downloading the Special Forces Group 2 by clicking on the button Download Special Forces Group 2 on PC that I have marked in green. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's an executable file. What we have to do is to run the installer, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I minimize the internet browser to find the installer better. The installation software is uncomplicated. It contains two options, install and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path does. We merely click on it. And therefore we note that we end up with here the path in which the emulator will be set up. If we wish to change this directory, we must click on this browse button, so we select another folder and set up the emulator precisely where we prefer. I prefer to set it where it is. I click on back. Therefore I simply click install. At this time, before beginning installing that emulator, it is possible that it'll show us one or more software offers to add on our desktop. Because I do not want to have any of those software program, I purely press each time on the reject option. Fantastic! The setup begins and it's going to proceed together with the download of these megabytes that are displayed on this screen. At the time you save it on your hard disk, it might possibly be more or less MB. The download rate will go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your web access and depending on the velocity of the emulator hosting servers. Today they are going very fast. The download is finished, and so right now it continues with the installation step. The installation will take more or less time depending on the strength of your PC. The more robust it really is, the faster the software installation time and or vice versa. If we put together the download and software installation stage, it normally takes quite a long time, so be patient. It has already completely finished on my side. At present, the emulator happens to be started instantly. As you can discover, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up, so when it gets to the end, the emulator will be launched for the very first time. Indeed, the emulator was already started, here for the first time. And as a result, LD Store is immediately started, that is a kind of Google Play. This is simply not the most correct way to install the game, therefore I do not endorse it, since possibly the LD Store sets up an out-of-date version of the Android game. Allow me to explain you the right way to install the game making use of the Google Play, and therefore I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we have to accomplish is to navigate to the desktop by hitting this icon that I am pointing out in green. Before we keep going, as you can see now, it has made two icons right here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon is the one we're interested in. Each time we choose to start Special Forces Group 2 on the laptop or computer, we twice mouse click on that app icon and start the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon is not related to multiplayer or anything at all like that. In reality, it is an icon that we might probably never ever utilize. Shall we perform the following step? That is a must, and that's to entry the Google Play Store. To execute this, we will go here to System Apps, we click. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can view, the Google Play is started. Right here we need to sign in. So now as soon as we're there, we must begin doing the next step, which is mandatory. So that we click on Sign In. Presently it shows Checking Info. It could from time to time get stuck in Checking Info, and this does not move forward. In this case, you could attempt to log in after a few hours, but it will surely almost certainly be fixed. At this time we're going to insert our username and password. The email has to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For instance, you can use the very same email address you're using currently in your own YouTube account. so that I will submit my details and I will return when I have done it. Voila, details typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us the terms of service. We are going to accept them by simply clicking on, I agree. Following that, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You could leave it checked and it will create a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. By now Google Play is started as preferred choice and immediately. If the Google Play isn't launched automatically and you do not know how to launch it yourself, I assist you how to achieve it. The very first thing is to proceed to the emulator desktop by clicking this software icon designated in green color. Straight away we head to the system apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Yes, we are right here within Google Play. What we're going to accomplish now is go here to search for apps and games. And thus we are going to do a search for Special Forces Group 2. Generally there we have it, we are going to click the first result. Listed here we have got the game app. Why don't we click there on the install button that I'm highlighting now in green. That click will commence the software installation. At this point it will download and install the game. It might take a while or perhaps it may be amazingly quickly. This all varies on the connection to the web. It's just ended setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by pressing this particular button that I am presenting in green, in order to launch Special Forces Group 2 for the first time. You are now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are going to just click on this new Special Forces Group 2 icon that has been generated. Your video game is started for the first time. There we get it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the volume level of this emulator. It is here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we could turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. This one is actually the first one. We mouse click on this software icon that I'm pointing out in green. Thus the monitor is maximized, offering one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Granted that we would like to have fun with the video game in full screen, we press on this icon. And thus we would likely at present be experiencing the game in full screen mode. To exit the full screen mode, click the F11 key. And additionally we would probably now end up being in normal computer screen mode. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate to you the computer keyboard mapping which is actually very interesting. This way we will likely be able to operate the video game far more effortlessly. The first point is to press this software icon. It's now time to get the required configurations. I am about to leave the default configuration, but if you need to change that, you can also do this with no problem. I grab this occasion to say that in some cases, when starting the video game a black screen appears. If this is like this and you discover the black screen and this emulator doesn't launch, I propose a viable fix. We can browse here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator options, in the advanced choice we get a number of graphic resolutions. This is the resolution that we have currently decided on by default, therefore we must select any of these additional graphic resolutions, for instance that one here. We take it and next click on save. It will require us to restart the emulator and once restarted, probably the emulator will start and that black display will go away completely. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is entirely in our own language. In some cases it happens that the emulator is launched in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese. And as a consequence to place it in the proper language we go here to the cogwheel. And thus there inside of additional settings, we just click on the language drop down. We could choose the language we want, English, Japanese, etc. After the language is selected, we are going to save, the emulator will reboot, and also the Android game, next time we use it, would also be in the chosen language. So now, there's another information that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail saying that a new equipment has been connected to our own Google account. It is going to check with us if we're the individuals who have associated with that electronic device. Yup, we may not worry, since the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. So you can find which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we come here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Let's go here to the model choice. And right here we see that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that training. I hope you enjoyed it, especially that you found it useful. In this case, give it a superb like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your feedback, issues or ideas, put them in the comment area below. You also can leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I do live streams occasionally, you get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of these videos which are usually showing up on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the next online videos. Bye.